Hello, welcome to my third article review for IT management. I'm really excited about the article this week. So I have a funny story just to preface my article. I've often asked people where the internet is. I genuinely have a question about how to locate it, where it is, where's the physical manifestation of the internet? And I think it's a question that most people just look at me and roll their eyes. And then the other question I've always asked is about the cloud. I just don't understand the concept. Where is the cloud? This kind of mythological place where things just go and you can pull it out of the cloud. So for a long time, I've been looking for a physical place to house things from the internet. And in my article, I actually think I found it. My article this week was called "The Enterprise Lacks a Big Data Strategy for IoT Transformation." Wow. It's a lengthy article, around 16 pages, but I really recommend it because it's very interesting. It's also very 2017. Apparently, this is an issue that is really coming to the forefront now for a particular reason. And the reason is this: the Internet of Things. Yes, I found my physical place, the Internet of Things, or IoT. The Internet of Things is the physical manifestation of the devices that we're all using, my cell phone to record this, but in addition, our Fitbits and our other tracking systems, even our coffee makers, even our cars. Every way that we're tracking and providing data to different companies, that's IoT. It's the things that are telling companies all about us. And I find that incredibly interesting. So companies are recognizing that there's a lot of value to IoT data. The article that I read was by Tony Turin, who's the global VP for Verizon. Verizon, as a phone company, has a unique perspective because they want to gather lots of data to analyze their customers. Turin talks about IoT data from the internet actually being so conclusive as far as giving a customer profile that in the future, he's saying, what if we could determine if someone was going to default on a loan based on the fact that they typed the loan out in all capital letters? So that might be a reach, but it's a good example of how strategic IoT data can be. There are some challenges with IoT data. First of all, it's really big data. We are providing so much information to different companies about ourselves, and we're providing it too quickly, so quickly that there's this churn. It's really hard to determine what's important and what's not. Most business leaders in a study said that they recognized that there was incredible value in the big data coming out of IoT. But only 18% said they even have the systems in place to analyze the data. So while there's this a massive amount, it's really hard to figure out what to do with it. The other thing that they know about IoT data is that it could really change the way that businesses are operating. It's the kind of data that, if done effectively, will completely change the systems and really impact the IT side of businesses. In fact, data-driven decision-making will be incredibly important, and IT will have a voice in shaping the vision of the business moving forward simply because of the IoT data that it can provide to the rest of the organization or the company. The benefits to IoT data would include customer service that increase and is better, but also the creation of new products. Because people are providing IoT data, we're inadvertently telling them things that are lacking, and companies can now customize things to meet the needs of customers that they didn't even know they needed. The challenge for IoT data right now is that while it's a wave of the future, it's going to quickly become something that is needed for companies. And leaders are identifying today that if they don't wrap their arms around this and find a way to really utilize it, that they won't be competitive in the marketplace. It's going to move fast, and it's going to shape and change the way that they're working with their customers. It also will really change how we get responses back from companies. I think IoT data will help us as customers become even more satisfied in our decision making. Anyway, that's it for me. I hope you enjoyed my presentation. I'll talk to you all later.